Our research entitled the Learning in the School of Education of the Polytechnic Institute of Porto is covered and dedicated evaluation in education and guidance. This study allows us to have an insight into the use of the Moodle platform in the classroom, and extra classroom teachers of ES. The experiment had its main goals, the second goal to realize the contours of the use that the teachers from ES make of the platform in the context of regular classes. And the second role, to understand which Moodle tools the teachers use in their teaching activities, both in classroom and outside the classroom, in this case, to promote the autonomous work of the students. And the third goal, to evaluate the pedagogical strategies developed and implemented by the teacher through the content provided by the Moodle platform. Our sample consists of 61 teachers representing all scientific areas of ES, 37 females and 24 males. Depending on the age, we divide the subject into four groups. The group one, between 20, 30 years old. Group two, between 31, 40 years old. Group three, 41 to 50 years old. And group four, over 50 years old. The data collection was made through teachers' response to an online survey about their use of the Moodle platform in the activities teaching. This survey was implemented on a Google Drive. When considering the use of the activities tools depending on the age groups, we have the following results. The group one did not use any of the activities tools. This particularly allows us to assume that they don't regularly use the Moodle platform. In group two and group four, the use of the activities tools is similar. And the group three only use the tools work, forum, database, and lesson. Comparing the behavior between the four age groups in the use of the activities tools, we can see that the group two, groups two, three, and four follow the same pattern. And the group one did not use any of the activities tools. As the global distribution of the resource tools concerns, we have the following results. The file is the tool that clearly stands out as the most widely used, followed by the second group, formed by the folder and the URL. Then a third group that consists of label and page. And the resource tools, book and IMS package, were not used by any teacher. When you consider the use of resource tools, depending on the age groups, we have the following result. Did not use the of the resource tool, any, similarly to what happened with the activities tools, and this confirms in our idea that this group probably does not regularly use the Moodle platform. The other case, in the other three groups, the use of the resource tool is similar. And the last, the book and IMS package were not used by any age group. Comparing the behavior between the four age groups in the use of the resource tools, we can see that the group 2, 3, and 4 followed the same pattern, and the group 1 did not use any of the resource tools. Considering the pedagogic strategies used by the teachers, we verify that they use the platform with two different purposes. One, as a document repository to support teaching activities in the classroom. And two, to provide documents to extra classrooms activities to promote and stimulate autonomous and independent work of the students. The conclusion of the study revealed that the majority of teachers of the ESE use the Moodle platform. The discipline format most used is the topics. Concerning the use of the activities tools, we see forum is the most used, followed by the work and the database. Workshop, SCORM, survey, pool, and text have a very residual use. LTI tool is never used. Concerning to the use of the resources tools, filed is the most used, followed by folder and URL, and then the label and the page. Book and IMS package are never used. Considering the pedagogic strategy, the majority of as teachers use the Moodle platform with two purposes. One, as a documentation repository to support their own teaching activities in the classroom, and two, to put documents directed to extra classroom activities, in this case to promote the autonomous work of the students. The age variable of these teachers, except for the youngest group, doesn't seem to play a significant role in differentiation of behaviors. And finally, young teachers are the ones who demonstrate less or the lowest use of the Moodle platform. It is curious that the group aged between 20 and 30 years old probably do not use the Moodle platform. Thank you very much for your attention.